Each evening during the centenary year, the last page will look back at the events of the Great War and at the stories of particular soldiers whose lives and deaths can tell us something about conflict. Tonight, we remember Private Jimmy Duffy, who died 100 years ago today, serving with the Canadian 16th Battalion. Jimmy was born in Sligo Island, and as a young boy, moved with his family to Edinburgh, where they changed the family name from McNiff to Duffy. After his education, he became a stonemason, and then became a famous athlete, winning many cross-country and long-distance races and championships. He left for Canada in 1911, where he continued his athletic career, and Jimmy was a member of the Canadian Olympic team in 1912. Jimmy won 9 consecutive marathons in 1913, including the New York and Boston marathons. At the outbreak of war, Jimmy volunteered, and he came over to France in early 1915. Jimmy was in the thick of the action as the Second Battle of England began on the 22nd of April. The town was under very heavy shell fire, and Jimmy was ordered to take position on the Isle Canal Bank. He watched as the terrified refugees streamed by, mixed with the French colonial troops running from the battlefield after being gassed. Jimmy then crossed the canal and into position, ready to take part in a counterattack at St. Julien against what became known as Kitchener's Wood. During the desperate fighting, Jimmy was mortally wounded when a shell burst close to him and he was hit in the head. The chaplain, Frederick Scott, found him and did his best to comfort him whilst arranging for him to be evacuated from the field. The chaplain waited with Jimmy until he was finally taken away by the stretcher bearers. Sadly, Jimmy's wounds were soon severe and he died later that day. Canon Scott buried him with many